Okay, guys, the topic that we have taken today, we have to discuss that if we have enough money to invest, so where we will go and invest. Okay, so if you talk about me, definitely in my case, if I have enough money, right, enough money in the sense, so much money, so what I will do firstly with that, definitely I will go with real estate part, there I will invest. But if I don't have enough money, just because if you want to invest in real estate, you need really enough money, right? More than crore rupees in few cases. Definitely, if you want to become a good real, I mean, you can start with minimum, but if you have enough money. But if we have minimal money, then definitely, firstly, I'll try to learn few skills like that. There is a like stock market. There we can firstly I'll spend my whole 4 to 5 months to learning that skill. Along with that, definitely few things that I can open a small companies that is totally based on like artificial intelligence, all those things, just because it is my interest. And apart from that, definitely nowadays the online education is trending, so I have also dream to somehow to reach to the student by this Zoom and by any other kind of platform. You all guys are aware about the Cambly app, right? So such kind of platform I also want to build, or maybe the better than that, right? So in all these places, definitely I would spend my all of the money that I, if I have enough money. Yeah, okay, this is all from my side for now. I mean, I can explain something more about it also. I mean, so much more, but I think for now it's good. Yeah, Sanjay?
Yeah. Yeah. First of all, good evening, everyone. Yeah. So if I have enough money, then I will definitely first want to start my own business. And I am really interested to open my own restaurant, and it's my dreams also. And I want to show the whole city that how like a restaurant owner be. So yeah, it's my dream. And otherwise, I also want to open a NGO, which is basically for the abandoned dogs and the cows who are, you know, moving around the roads. Sometimes they got accident by cars and something, and they are badly damaged and they have badly injuries. So at that point, we need to give some facilities. So I want to open an NGO for the dogs and the cows, and it's absolutely want to run my own expense. So yeah, these things I really want to do if I have enough money.
Yeah, that's great, Sanjay. Kajo?
Yeah.
Actually, right now I got the topic and I didn't see what's the topic, but still I want to mention some point actually. Yeah. And it's just, you know, suddenly happened with me. So I was just thinking that first of all, if I have money, because I have a plan, like first of all, I have to take some job. Mm-hmm. And I want to invest some money in mutual fund or some kind of thing, because I had seen some videos and I want to invest because after 1 or 2 years, I want to start my own business. So that's why at least if I started investing in some good company, then at that time I can get, you know, a good amount so that I'm able to start my own business. So it will not pressurize my parents too. So that's why, first of all, I try to invest on some good, like as mutual fund, you also heard about the name. So, so first of all, I will definitely do that. And if I am successful in business, if I earn a good money and a handsome money, so I think at that time, I would love to learn new things. Like there's a lots of things I really want to learn. So first of all, I want to learn music, because I really want to join any music class. But right now, it is not like I want to become a singer. It's not like that. But I want to learn. It's my hobby. So that's why I want to learn. Second thing is that I also want to right now I'm unable to join any yoga class or anything, but I want to join actually yoga class. So that's my actually plan. I know it's not like that. I can do yoga right now also, but still I want to join because I want to know more about it. So that's why I want to join. I want to get some knowledge because this fact, if you want to take some good knowledge, so you can go through the some experience holder. So that is a requirement, no doubt. So yeah, that's my point. And I also want to start some education based thing, which I can't mention here, but yeah, that's my dream actually. There are something which I want to start. It's related to education actually, which I am hoping. So yeah. But in India, I think it takes time to pursue over that thing. But still, I want to start. So that's my point. And later, I will put my more point if I have anything.
Yeah. Okay. Neha?
Yes.
Yeah.
So... So hello everyone, hope so all are you fine. And as we know that today's topic is where would you like to invest. So first of all, I want to say something like rather than saving, I would like to invest. Because lots of people are believe in saving and lots of people are believing investment, and I believe in investment. Because investment is something which will provide you much more than saving. And in saving, if you are going with the bank, yeah, anywhere, so you will get 10 or 12% interest with that. But if you're going to invest in place, yeah, in any business model, so you will get much more than that. And for that, you have to just need of some skills. So for that... I would say to you can do job in their field. Yeah, you can do a job. Yeah, you can train yourself, do under someone, anything you want. So it's just like that you can earn and learn something. And if I'm talking about myself, I'm working on that. And basically, I'm a student, but after getting some financial knowledge through some books, and I'm a commerce student from there also. So I have my small restaurant on which my father and we are both working. And also I have a small business model, which is only which provide online groceries and fruit. It's not a big channel, but it's very small because I'm just starting from 1 month ago, and it's just starting, but we are doing very well, and we are just providing, I'm just providing groceries and fruits at a very, very few reasonable cost because we are direct contact to the market sellers, and we are just direct contact to the consumers. So it's a way we are working. So according to me, I don't think so. If you want to do something, so there is a need of too much capital for investing. You can start with a very small and with a few savings. Like I want a initial in an initial level. You, if you want to start your any business, you can start with a 20K. 20 to 30K. In fact, lower than that, if you want to start. And rather than a job, we should definitely do any business, because what you can do in job, you can just, you will never enjoy your life. You can just live your life, but not never enjoy. But in business, you can do whatever you want. So basically what I want to share, we should always job is good, but till then when you just want to learn, In fact, I will. I'm also after completion of my graduation, I will also joining the job, and for 1 to 1.5 year for getting experience how the management work and how the everything is a work in a practical way. I know how to work because I did many more thing in my past, some intensive whatever. But I want to get more experience. And you can get only you can get this thing from your if you are gonna to doing something. So, but after this, we all should start us some small business because don't think there is something risky at all. These are lots of business ideas you can do, and we must do. And so I really love to invest my money. In fact, I have 1,000, 100, 2,000, 10,000, many more. I never like to saving. I am always like to invest anywhere I want. So yeah. This is from all my side, and thank you so much.
Yeah, that's really great. Okay, Shivam, you want to speak? Shivam, unmute yourself firstly. Okay, Sunil.
Yeah, all right. So, good evening, everybody. And okay, just a moment.
Okay, I forgot to mention the topic because I had suddenly got the topic, that's why. So yeah, there are something which I really want to do. Like I also want to invest in real estate, as you said. Dhruv, you also mentioned about it. And actually, my father also had some kind of what we say is
land.
Place. Land. Yeah, land. Exactly. I forgot the word. So yeah, so I want to invest on all those things because I think no doubt real estate is one of the best thing that you know that you can do in to earn a good amount of money. So at that time, first of all, I have to invest on all those things. So I think that I really want to do. And next thing is that I love traveling. So I would love to, you know, travel on the city, different cities. So I'd love to travel because it is one of the, you know, most reliable thing for me, I think. And the next thing is I actually have some spiritual attraction. So that's why I want to know much about the spirituality. So I would love to go and you know learn some different religion also, so that I am able to connect with whatever you know the energies, you can say.
Yeah.
So that's my hope that I will do it. And I forgot one more thing. So okay then.
Yeah. Okay. Mention later. Yeah. Sunil.
Yeah. So sorry for inconvenience. Previously I couldn't proceed. Okay. So we specifically talking about the investment. So my first priority is to invest in real estate because we have not big land, but yeah, still we have conventional land that I got from ancestor, and we earning from that even without hard working, we just gave money on lease. So my first priority is to enlarge the land area that we already have. So I want to invest in that field. And apart from this, apart from agriculture land, my priority would be in invest in real estate, that we just acquire a small area of land and then we, you know, hold for some period of time, and then the price, you know, spike, then we just sell. So it's a very, you know, easy process. We all know about this and many questions doing already. So this is great idea to multiply our monies. And if you ask about my experience, then unfortunately I failed in the stock market. I earned money from my hard working. I got liquid from my job. I worked more than a year, and then I saved money in my bank account. But unfortunately, without proper knowledge, or you can say out of greed, I just without my mind, I just invest in a stock market. And unfortunately, I invested in the Yes Bank. And then the Yes Bank collapsed and I lose my money. So that was my failure model, you can say. But now if you ask me, then I want to invest in real estate. I personally think that is much safe compared to stock market or mutual fund or other things. So acquiring land, that is, I think, more safe. And if we invest in a strategic way, if we, you know, consider future as well, that I'm investing in particular land area or in a specific area, that maybe price will hike or maybe it's nearby the big city. So in upcoming year, the value of land, it naturally increase. So we can, you know, apply such strategy. And yeah, I heard one of the panelists among us mentioned about the investing money. So yeah, it's really good to invest money instead of saving in bank account. If we just put money in bank account, then I think that's not good idea. That from that we will just get interest like 2%, 3% or 4%. And if you invest in FD, then you will, I think, maximum you will get like up to the 7 or 6%. So that's not good idea. We should invest, but I think we should invest in chunks. Not like if I have like 1 crore and I saved 1 crore from my blood and my sweat, I earned very badly. I invested my everything, and without any mind, I just invest whole money, whole my saving 1 crore in one area. That is really bad. We should, you know, try in various fields. Like if I investing my 1 crore on a single area of land, that's not good. I should, instead of that, I should invest like 10 lakhs in 10 area of land. So that would be, I think, much. I can get maximum money. I can get back maximum money. Okay, so I think we have not much time.
We have enough time if you want to make some more point. But yeah, like even I agree with you in terms of stock market and other, no matter whatever the investment you are going to make. But I think first of all, we have to use our brain. At least we need to give at least 4 to 5 months, 6 months, 3 months, no matter you are going in the business of real estate. No doubt in real estate, at least your money will be money, and there are more chances that the rate, the price of that land will grow. But it also depends on the site that you are taking. There might be no one, there will be no market, then the price will be the remain same. And it can also go down if there will be some.
But Drew, if you compare, you know, that acquiring land business to stock market, then there is a minimum risk.
Stock market, you must have some experience and knowledge. That is really important.
For that,
our knowledge, our great experience, they failed.
Things totally go
wrong. Because the business model designed in such a way that is, you know, people, that's why I call it gambling more than stocking or exchanging. People call it, it's a gambling. You know, especially Indian afraid, most of the Indian afraid to investing in stock market. So that's,
you know, one of my close friend is also lost his 5 lakh rupees. Actually, he had learned a good amount. He had earned a good amount of money at approx 1 year. And after that, you know, suddenly yeah, he lost, years. Suddenly Same he year. Lost yeah, his 5 lakh actually.
That's why, you know, we have to keep in mind that it's not gonna happen in one day. Use at least your half an hour, 1 hour every single day that we can invest in learning that thing. And after 1 year, after 6 months or 8 months, when we are pretty sure means damn sure, definitely, like we are damn sure about that, and definitely experience help you. And like Sunil has mentioned, definitely. Exactly. If you are going to put your whole 1 crore or $1 million in just one single bucket,
it is a foolishness, actually.
Definitely. We should try in multiple business model. We should try and invest in multiple model instead of only
2 lakh rupees, yeah. 5 lakh rupees. That is how we learn. No matter it's a stock market, we can start with just 500, 1,000 rupees. Why we need to put 5 lakh directly if we don't know anything about that? Right.
And yeah. And through here the idea of giving money on interest, that is not also bad. We can yeah. you know take some liquid from person, mm-hmm. or we can just you know sign the paper or the stamp, or the we can just sign the land paper, then we can give our money on interest, like yeah. simple interest, 2 rupees, 3 rupees. That's also not bad idea. People also earning from this method. This is also safe.
Yeah.
Exactly. And good idea. Yeah.
Yeah. And same, all these things, you know, also equally true with business. We put our money in business, yeah. then the chances of like 50-50% or maybe sometimes 100% to get lose all the money.
Yeah. And without knowing without having a good knowledge, we just, you know, like invest our all the money. So I think that is not good.
Yeah.
First of all, we should aware about many things.
But
we should
still
take knowledge. I think that is really good.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm saying here that after all the risk or after all the problems, I would say business is far better than job. It's far better than job. It's depend on individual. It's depend on individual interest. But it's in term of earning money. In term of earning money, job is not the way. It's just for bread and butter or just for the surviving. Yeah. But if you want to mm-hmm. earn money, then I think only business. That's the way. We can match and multiply our money.
Yeah, Neha, you wanted to say something?
Yeah.
Shivam,
you want to speak?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Neha, go ahead.
Yes, I want to say if we want to invest money, so we should start from very initial, and we don't. Right. If we don't have any experience, or also if we are gonna to start any business, so firstly we should analyze the environment, what the need of environment. Then we go and we should do something regarding the any business, because some more people what they are doing, they are just see that like there is too much return. ROI, so they are just gonna to invest, but they didn't say what the condition of our environment and what's going on. They are just going and put, and they getting too much loss.
Exactly.
I'm also living here, where I'm living. Here are in this lockdown. Here are lots of restaurants open mm-hmm. during this lockdown. But what happened? They are investing almost 2 to 3 to 4 lakh in their restaurant. But what happened? They have to just close their restaurant within 2 to 3 months. Why? Because of the environment. As we know that this is the corona time, and no one want to go outside and just go to eat any food or whatever. If there are chances of like 20-30%, they are go and they are just eating. But and they didn't see. They are just was like we have a amount and we can just start. So we should, if we are going to start any business, so we should firstly analyze the environment. But in this pandemic, the two businesses are which we can easily running, like for the medicine, because and for the groceries, yeah, we can say necessary food, yeah, we can work on those things which is necessary nowadays.
Education.
If we are talking
about that education.
Yeah, and education also. Like lots of people are in their home. We can like you were saying, that we can start some channel through we can educate people. So there is a way we can earn much and more money. So lots of ideas, but we wouldn't take any step toward this because of just only risks. But I think we should start and not to we don't should put much more money. I think we should just put some money after then getting, then it will go into twice
yeah
from their business. So this is the way we can earn.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. Drew, here I want to mention a practical and the real life example from my side that some time ago my elder brother invested in the textile industry. So he owned a machines. So here I want to make a point that all person has not that mind, you know, the business mind. That is crucial reality. So he's good in earning through the job. but he's not good in the business, because business require, you know, a lot of hard work. If you going to, you know, in job that simply it's 9 to 5, then you just need to put, you know, your 8 to 9 hours. But if you are starting your own business, then maybe you need to work more than 60, 70 or more than 20 hours in a day. So firstly, we should have courage, and firstly, we should have, you know, that much capability to bear the pain. So here, my example, I every day watch my brother, my elder brother, what mistake he's doing. So he simply, you know, treating his business like his job. He just giving his 8 to 9 hours. And I many time insist him, I said him that, dear, if you are just investing your 8 to 9 hours, then please don't expect return like a business. You will get only return like your job. If you treat your business like a job, then your business treat you in the same way. It's a vice versa. So here, my point is here, firstly, we should have, you know, capability of bearing that pain. That pain is overworking or overtiming. We should have that capability, and every business requires that kind of hard work. I think every business initially, especially in initial time, because there is consolidation time, and that period we need to put extra hour, extra effort, extra knowledge. We also need to educate ourselves in that particular time, or maybe that time require a teamwork as well. Our team worker not working that time, maybe you need to work more than your workers. Maybe you need to work as a labor in your business. That's not bad. If you handling kind of business, there, you know, required labor. So maybe sometime you also need to work as a labor, and there's nothing wrong to work like a labor.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I agree.
It's our business.
Yeah, definitely.